Hello guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new to my channel, hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Summer. So today's video, I want to talk about this coming fall in Ikeji. Like, we call it coming fall because it's been going on for a very long time. Linda Ikeji is a Nigerian blogger. She's a Nigerian blogger, and I think she's believed to be the most popular Nigerian blogger. I think she's the most popular Nigerian female blogger, or the most successful, or the most, I've forgotten what they call it. So she made the post on Instagram. This lady, people have been coming for her for like a long time, you know, and it's always about that she's not married. She's not married. She doesn't have a husband and all of those things. A few years ago, she was pregnant and she had the baby, but she wasn't married. There was so much that was said about her. They said it was a sperm donor. They said she went to a sperm bank. There was nothing they didn't say, all of those things. And then there was a general belief that since she was not married and she saw that she wasn't getting any younger, that it's possible she decided to just go ahead and just, you know, have a baby and all of that. People still come for her all the time. She has this massive house in Nigeria, and I think is in an expensive part of Lagos and all of that. She drives expensive cars and she has massive wardrobe. She's the type that she posts a lot on Instagram about her life, her house and all of that. It was her 40th birthday, and you know, I think when it was her 40th birthday, she made this post and she said, then, you know, she said she got herself 40 designer shoes and 40 designer bags as her 40th birthday present to herself and all of that. So, but the thing is, it happens to be that every time she makes, typically when she makes a post to talk about what she's doing with her life, or she shows her new car, or she shows her house or whatever, there's always going to be people that say, oh, but you don't have a husband. Oh, you don't have a husband. So recently she made the post. She showed her jacuzzi, and this is the post anyways. And she posted this picture and she captioned it, "My view is better than anything I ever imagined. May what happens for you in real life be greater and better than anything you ever wished, hoped, and prayed for yourself." And that was the post she made. And one of the comments said, "This jacuzzi needs a hymn." Okay, this jacuzzi needs a hymn. So it still goes back to this people coming for her for not being married and saying that this jacuzzi needs a hymn. I read that and I thought to myself, is a hymn, you know, a necessity that is mentioned in the instruction manual? Like, the manufacturer said, you know, after you connect it to electricity, you know, add a hymn in the jacuzzi before it can function. So how does the jacuzzi need a hymn? I always say it, marriage is a beautiful thing, especially if you find the right person. Because if you meet the wrong person, you would regret the day you got married. Sometimes we forget that aspect of it. If people marry the wrong people, they will regret the day they ever got married. They will know that single life can be heaven. So let's not forget that aspect of things. Marriage can be a beautiful thing if you meet the right one. But why always put it in somebody's face all the time? Oh, you're not married, da 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 da. Some of the comments that replied to this person said, so like this comment said, "Get out of her space." I think meant that IF meant to say off her space. Another comment says, "Nobody literally cares about your opinion." Another comment says, "You with a him, is your life better? Anako." I don't know what anako means. And then this one says, "A very dark mentality." Like I said, there's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with having a hymn, okay? But it's just the way that this has been what she has been dragged for such a long time, that she's not married. All the time they come for her for that. Anyways, few days later, she posted this picture of her son. Maybe it's a way of saying that there's actually a hymn in my house that can get in this jacuzzi. I know there was a drama about when she had a child and everything. And I remember making a video and saying that I personally feel like, okay, we are going to come out and say having a baby out of wedlock is not the right thing to do. At the end of the day, she fell pregnant, she carried her baby, and she had her baby. We're not going to come here and say that abortion is the right thing. There are a lot of ladies that have no babies, not because they were never pregnant. There are a lot of ladies that are not married and never got babies, not because they are saints, not because they are angels, not because they were never pregnant, but simply because their own babies are in the grave. Okay? So I remember making a post then, and I said it, that if you people that do that, that, you know, they're gonna be, I have no baggage, I have no babies. The thing is this, you're a mother, only that you're a mother to a dead child. That's the difference. You know, let's be honest, those people have babies as well, only that they are mothers to dead babies. And the men are fathers to dead babies. So let's be careful about pointing fingers at someone else because she carried her baby and gave her baby life. Another thing is people forget that she's not going to marry herself. She still has to wait for somebody to propose. Because somebody proposed does not necessarily mean she has to say yes. Because there are some people that at her position may have gotten desperate. Another truth is that there are some people that if they were in her position, they would be like, let me just marry anybody to please social media. Let me just marry so I can answer married woman. And then she marries this person, then at home, it's hell. But she comes to the public and she smiles and be like, she'll be a missus in the eyes of the world. But at home, she's living in hell. Marriage is not something you just go into to please people. Okay? Like I said, she can't marry herself. She still has to wait for somebody to come along that would propose and stuff like that. Another thing is this. Our emphasis on marriage. Yeah. Jesus did not marry you. We forget sometimes. Marriage is a beautiful thing, but it's not a ticket to heaven. Like the other day I made the video. You know, the way we treat women in our society. This girl, they never stop coming for her. I made a video not too long ago when I was talking about Don Jazzy. Don Jazzy is 38 or whatever years they said. This guy is not married. As far as we know, he doesn't have any kids. You know, and nobody is dragging him. I made a video not too long ago. I talked about it. Nobody is dragging him about, oh, look at him. He's not even married. Look at him. All his mates are married. No. He's still celebrated and loved and everything. Why is it when it comes to women, to be dragging women from here to Sokoto because she's not married? It's too much. It's too much. They have been coming for her for like you would think this would get old. It has not gotten old. People are still coming for her all the time. She has made posts where she said that, you know, she'd like to have a man. But what do you want her to do when it has not happened? And why is it always necessary? Almost all the time they come for her for that. If you have husband, send husband to her now. Abi, if you're distributing husband, why not distribute husband to her? Anyways, I saw that and I just thought to myself, you know, when will that ever stop? When will they stop all this coming for her for not having a husband? And I saw the picture of the son and I thought to myself, like, I'm going to be honest, I saw that, I was like, wow, he's such a big boy now. And I thought about the fact that there are some other women that would have gotten rid of that pregnancy, that would have gotten rid of their baby because, oh, the world is going to laugh at me because I'm having a baby out of wedlock and all of that. And if she had followed that line, if she had told that line, she wouldn't have this beautiful baby boy, you know, to behold. She would not have this beautiful baby boy, you know, to call her own. And I, to be honest with you, I was so, like, in my heart, looking at that boy, you know, looking at that boy and thinking about all the other women or ladies that would have gotten rid of their own pregnancies, how, you know, what they would have missed out on. You keep talking about things like this and some people don't seem to change, but we'll keep speaking. And hopefully, a day will come where we'll stop attacking people for not being married. You know, you see, you know what's funny is that it's always fellow women that come for each other. You will see another woman. You see, that will come for the woman for not being married or have children, or not being married but have no children, or the husband has one leg. That is another thing. You will see, I have seen single ladies that are looking for husband though, that have not seen, will not go and laugh at somebody, say the husband has one leg or the husband has one eye. Go and see the one that one is marrying now. The ladies that are praying for husband will laugh at somebody else. Oh, the husband is this, is that. You're praying for husband, you have not seen. This I'm talking about, we women, how we go for each other. Then instead of the person to focus on their own and say, okay, well, let me find my own, is it that? And then a woman that is not married, that does not conceive, is another problem. Do you know that she has married for 10 years, no pregnancy? The one that has pregnancy but are giving birth to daughters, and see, she has 5 children, not a single boy among only daughters. And most of the time, it is we women that come for each other. Most of the time. I'm telling you, I've said it before, that men cannot oppress us. Men cannot oppress us without the help of women. We are our own worst enemies. This comment now that this person is a woman, is a fellow woman that left it. Anyway, I don't want this video to be too long. I just saw that and I wanted to come and share it. And then, as always, whatever your opinions are, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. And with that, I'm going to say thank you for watching. Until the next time, guys. Bye-bye. Bye.